as the world moves to its end point, civilization begins to collapse, starting to unravel right now. As it collapses, it's an excellent time to get an overview of existence. And you find out that existence is literally the attempt to replace reality with a new reality. That's the idea. That's the seed that gives rise to the tree of existence. And the purpose is to negate. So existence is essentially negative or negating. Of course, you can't negate a vacuum, can you? A void. Nothing to negate. So first you have to fill the void to overflowing with what appears to be activity defined as life, and then negate that life, and then claim that this is evidence that reality can be replaced. That's what's actually taking place. That's what existence is. That's the purpose. That's the dynamic of existence. It cannot be changed. The only thing that can be changed is the idea. Choose a new idea. You can't change the effects of an idea into some other effects relating to some other idea. It's impossible. Cause and effect are two sides of one coin. Okay, so salvation from this idea is the goal of all of us, because we want to choose a new idea, but we feel fixated, trapped with on this one idea due to what I call the logic of plausibility, which is the defense system of this idea, which keeps us bound to this idea, keeps our attention on this idea. We're fixated on it to the exclusion of all our ideas, and we don't believe, we've forgotten that we can choose a new idea. We have forgotten that. It's taboo. We don't even think about that. I've been in this world 55 years. I've studied every kind of religious and spiritual teaching. I have never, ever come across a single statement of saying choose a new idea. Okay. Course of Miracles came close. It was in the ballpark, saying exchange belief systems. Okay, but actually, what you really need to do is choose a new idea. It's taboo. Nobody even talks about it. Why? Because everyone's following a path of what's called spirituality. And let me tell you, spirituality is the polar opposite of salvation. It's that which keeps you fixated on this idea. It does not free you. It doesn't save you. It doesn't bring you to choosing a new idea. So that pathway is what is being sponsored and pushed in existence as your happiness, as the way to be happy. And spirituality takes on many, many, many forms. But I tell you, that is the road to continued damnation, continued involvement with this idea of negation. Everything is being negated in existence constantly. It's the dualistic dynamic of construction and destruction. Everything that's constructed arises so that it can then be destructed or negated to manufacture evidence of plausibility that reality itself can be replaced, even though it doesn't touch reality. Reality is untouched. The greatest witness you can do in this world, the greatest good, is not how you can touch this world and make it better, but rather how you can show that you're untouched by this world. And this world does not touch you at all. There have been those in this world like that who have not been touched at all. Ananda Maima was one of those. The world never touched her in the slightest way. Okay, and we saw that and we said, ha ha. Reality is untouched. There's something that is untouched. This world cannot touch. And she said, of course, we know reality. Reality itself is untouched by dreams of its demise, dreams of its negation. And yet we continue to follow past the spirituality, even though teachers point out that spirituality is the worst thing you can pursue. Teachers and gurus come in this world, they teach the truth, and everybody thinks they're teaching spirituality. And they say, oh, great, here's a teacher, spiritual teacher who can teach us spirituality. And they get into it and try to learn affection and love and all these spiritual things instead of learning clarity and recognizing that the remedy, the sovereign remedy, is to choose a new idea. That's the only way to be freed of the effects of this idea, the only way. You cannot spiritualize this idea. Trying to replace reality, it still is entirely negating everything. You cannot worship nature and think that you're going to be free from it. There's nothing you can do other than choosing a new idea. So if you're not focusing in on that, you're not going to get there right now. You're delaying. You're using delaying tactics. You're remaining fixated on the idea to the exclusion of all other ideas. Keep in mind that as we are experiencing this play of existence, this dance of construction and destruction, We're not choosing any other ideas. We're not experiencing any other ideas. And we've been fixated on this idea for how long? That's not what we were created for. We're free to remain fixated, but we're created to choose ideas and play with ideas and move fluidly from one idea to another idea. Not to, and these ideas are not meant to exclude other ideas, but this one idea that we're trying to experience, replacing reality with a new reality, its main purpose is to claim that all other ideas are excluded, they're non-existent, they're wiped out, gone. Can't choose them because they're no more. They've been negated. Now that is not the purpose that we are created for, to choose an idea that negates all their ideas and remain fixated on that idea. No, not at all. So it's what we call the goddess is the sponsor of spirituality, and she claims she's co-redemptress with what we call Christ, which is the voice which leads us to actual salvation and choosing a new idea. And she says that she and Christ are working together as co-sponsors of salvation. That is not true. She sponsors spirituality, okay, and leads everybody astray and keeps everyone fixated on the idea of existence, whereas Christ wakes you up to clarity. Call it Christ's clarity. Helps you see that the remedy is to choose a new idea. It's not to try and spiritualize the idea. Not at all. You're not called to be some affectionate, loving person and making everybody feel more comfortable about being fixated on this idea. You're called to clarify, okay, to be clear about this idea and to be clear about reality and how reality functions, and to be clear that cause and effect are two sides of one coin. They cannot be separated. You choose an idea like trying to replace reality, you're going to have effects from that are going to be negating. And like I said, you cannot negate a vacuum, a void, so you have to fill that with constructs. And all we're experiencing here is constructs being negated. And that'll never satisfy us. We'll never be happy being fixated on this one idea. And the very purpose of the idea is to negate us. We are spirit, and we are part of reality. And this idea is attempting to destroy reality. So it's really attempting to destroy ourselves. So we identify with these bodies, with these constructs, and then experience these constructs being negated, being destroyed, being killed, died. And we say, oh, isn't this terrible? It's horrible. This is all being negated. And there's something feels terrible about it. We don't like it. We're not comfortable. And yet we try to spiritualize it. We try to follow the goddess as she teaches. Well, you can be happy with this. You can be happy with death and dying. It's all part of a natural cycle. Everything's evolving. Don't worry. All of that is to keep us fixated. You don't have to spend another moment on this idea. There's a zero to be gained by existence. There's nothing to be learned. All you have to do is realize that you're completely free. You have the authority to choose a new idea right now. And then do that. That is what we should be aiming for. That's what the clarity is for. Very simple. Very simple, and yet it's completely taboo in existence. Why nobody listens and nobody pays any attention. The goddess says, don't listen to that person, that one who's speaking. Nonsense, nonsense, nonsense. You need to learn how to hold hands and chant and make the world a more loving, more peaceful place and beautify it and all this stuff. That's the nonsense. That's the goddess nonsense. Okay, that's the way, one of the ways that we remain fixated. A powerful, powerful play of plausibility that makes us believe that we got to keep working and on this one idea, make it better, instead of choosing a new idea. Christ's clarity will tell you, choose a new idea. Never tells you to try to make this world a better place. Never. None of that. You don't need to do any of that. That's not the point. You don't need to build any more churches or temples or religious structures or spiritual structures. You don't need to set up any more retreats. You don't need to take part in any of that. No need for any of that, trying to spiritualize this world or planet or existence or cosmos, universe. It's all there, an attempt to negate. It will always be that way, no matter what you do. So get wise, get Christ clarity. Turn to the idea of choosing a new idea. Turn to that recognition, awareness, choose a new idea. I can choose a new idea. I have the power, the authority, the capacity given to me by the Prime Creator. And all ideas are also available to me, made available by the Prime Creator. So I can choose a new idea any moment. And I'll always be free to choose another idea at any moment. I'm never bound to any idea. That's the truth. That's Christ's clarity. Okay.